a year to build again on old foundations. So old foundations is not our past life or a sinful lifestyle or something that we walked out of, right? Old foundations is the original blueprint, the original vision, the original intent or purpose that God has for us. So God is inviting us as a congregation, is inviting us to build again. And he's saying, this is the instruction. Would you step into it? Would you build again? And as you build again, he's saying, this is my promise that not only will you experience, will you see things raised up, but also it'll become a lifestyle, it'll become a ministry where you will raise up, repair, rebuild, restore things in people's lives. We're going back to the blueprint. We're saying, God, this is your word. This is what you said. So I'm on the assignment to rebuild according to your blueprint. And God says, you have my favor. You have my approval. Go ahead. Do it. He's backing us up. Now maybe we're thinking of building again with several areas that we listed. And we're wondering, Lord, how can I build? But God says, I'll release my favor. I'm releasing my favor. I'm releasing my resources. And as we start the process, he gives his resources, revelation, wisdom, encouragement from his word, and all that we need, the know-how. You know, he sends people, he guides us to certain, maybe a workshop or some meeting, somewhere where he builds us up. He gives us the resources for the inner man. For in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. In the presence of God, there is peace. In the presence of God, there is restoration for our soul, for our emotions. So emotionally, you know, we may not be capable. We're saying, God, this is too tough. This is too difficult. How can I build again? Every time I take a step to build again, I'm just assaulted by regrets. I'm assaulted by, you know, all the things that I did. They start taunting. They're saying, they start ridiculing. They start laughing at them. And that is also true. Many times we are unprepared for that, right? Saying, God, this is your work. You have asked me to rebuild. You have asked me to do this. You have asked me to repair. And I'm doing it according to your blueprint. And what is this that I'm facing? And if you read Nehemiah, you see that it's not a one-time thing. They come, and as soon as they hear, they start ridiculing, they start discouraging, they start laughing, mocking at them. Then Nehemiah says, no, we will continue. He prays, he continues. Then halfway through, the wall is just half built to half of its height. And then we see that again, all of them band together, and then they start ridiculing, mocking. And they make a joke about it and say, even if a fox walks on its walls, it'll bring everything down. And that's not all. The work is over, almost over. The wall is rebuilt. What remains is just for the gates to be placed there. Even then, they are conspiring. And they're saying, call him out. They're inviting him to come to the plains. Four times they do that, saying, you know, let's conspire, let's finish him off. And the fifth time, they send another letter, and let's do this. And Nehemiah is so focused. He says, no, no. He doesn't even respond. He doesn't even bother. He says, I'm just focused. He keeps going. But he does something, you know, which is something that we need to learn. He prays to God and he arms his people so that they are alert. They are alert. They have their weapons. They are alert. They are armed. And they're standing there. We are praying. They are alert. And that's something for us to learn, that even as we start the work of rebuilding, repairing, restoration, it is required of us to watch out for this and to be alert. We have already been clothed with the armor of God, that we stand with the armor. Now, it doesn't say that they fought, actually. They just stood. They stood their ground. They stood alert. And the enemy did not even attack.